Have you here live from the SCC studios in White Bear Lake, also playing live over SPNN in St. Paul. And interesting show today. You want to watch for a number of reasons. Got a lot of updates, small updates on the judiciary and school issues and your liberty issues and the effect of the LGBTQ policies that are being established, how Christians are being crucified for that, and a number of judicial issues. And then we're going to get into this cable commission thing with Maplewood. Maplewood has done something to deprive residents of services. At the same time, they're going to make more money. Okay. The city, they're going to deprive services and make more money, and you need to know about this. It's just wrong because you're paying for it and you're paying for a specific service, and Maplewood is picking and choosing their special people that they want to get the money, and you're not getting it, and you're not going to get the service. So we want to we're going to show a number of video on that, and then also Maplewood had a human rights commission meeting, and which basically made Maplewood a sanctuary city without notice. No document came out the day of the meeting, of the approval of the meeting. They didn't even have it to discussion for the month before. The public didn't have it. Anybody speaking at that commission had no idea what was being proposed. And so we're going to talk about that. And then if we have more time, we'll do other things. First thing, judicial system. After 16 years, a DNA test clears a man of rape. This was in California. Innocence Project at the California Western School of Law in San Diego helped a guy through the DNA. In other words, here's a man who had to listen to testimony of people accuse him of rape, and it wasn't him. And there was the evidence there, and it took forever to get the evidence into the court, and 16 years, he's exonerated. Pretty emotional experience, as you can imagine. Here we got a judge that's been asked to resign in Pennsylvania. Governor Wolf called on Pennsylvania Justice Michael Eakin to resign Saturday, after the newspaper there, the Inquirer, reported that the justice was part of a ploy to install a sympathetic appointee to the Judicial Disciplinary Tribunal expected to decide his fate in the pornographic email scandal. quite a deal, you know. I mean, he appoints this judge under investigation, appoints people to the investigative committee. All right, good stuff. That doesn't happen here, you know, and you know why it doesn't happen? Is because they haven't been caught. You know, so the courts can say, well, it doesn't happen. Well, if you want to know about David Knutson, and we've talked about him a lot, the former state senator, and now district court judge in Dakota County, also on the board on judicial standards, which is supposed to oversee the discipline of judges. I can see having a judge there, but he's kind of the head person, the chair of this board. He's not running the board on judicial standards, but he is the lead person in the meetings, and he's got disciplinary actions going against him and complaints. Yet he's still on the board. How are the other people on the board supposed to deal with that? You know, federal lawsuits against him. That's just some judicial stuff. Let's see if I have another one. Okay, bathroom policies for schools and locker rooms. Alliance Defending Freedom has filed a friend of the court brief Tuesday with the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Fourth Circuit on behalf of the Family Foundation of Virginia and concerned parents concerned parents, students, and community members who support the Gloucester County School Board restroom policy. That policy preserves restrooms and changing areas for members of the same biological sex while providing an alternate private facility for students struggling with sexual identity issues. You know, instead of forcing your ideology on people, there's a sensible policy. If a kid's struggling with sexual identity, doesn't have an adult there to tell them whether they're a male or a female, you know, not willing to do the DNA chromosome test to figure that out, they can have a safe place to go. Why, so does everybody else. All right. Here's part of the problem already coming up. Teachers are being fired if they don't address a child according to that child's biological preference. So there's a teacher in Texas who was fired for not referring to a six-year-old girl as a boy. So Madeline Kirksey, she was a manager at Children's Lighthouse Learning Center in Texas, and one girl had been attending the school for several months. After leaving school one Friday, named Sally, she came back to school on Monday with a new haircut, claiming to be named Johnny. Kirksey was fired after refusing to refer to the female child as a male or call her Johnny. Kirksey now claims that this firing was religious discrimination. That's what's coming to St. Paul. You know, so teachers, everybody loses their freedom of speech in this deal. Of course, Betty McCollum has co-sponsored an LGBTQ RST Equity Day resolution. And understand this is the same thing that happened in Nazi Germany, in the beginning of Nazi Germany, with Hitler and the brown shirts, getting all these people in the service. And then part of taking over a country is to flood your people into another country. So Betty McCollum has already come out that she's on the side of the terrorists by not having secure borders in the United States. And allowing refugees, as she would say, these refugees are women and children, allowing these Muslim refugees in. But if you look at the statistics and you look at the pictures that are out there, most of these are young men without women and children. Okay? This is a plan. This isn't accident. This isn't, oh, things are out of control. Well, things are out of control anyway. Get them in control. Do what Trump and Cruz and Rand Paul are saying. Hey, don't shut down immigration from any of these countries that are on our terrorist watch list. Get it right. You know, vet these people before you let them in. And of course, Obama, who is a Muslim, I mean, there isn't any question about that. I mean, how would somebody behave if they were a Muslim but trying to hide it? Okay? They would behave like President Obama does. And oh, by the way, guess what? There is not going to be Christmas at the White House this year. Where is that deal? Christmas is canceled. And instead, they're going to have, if I can find it here, a different day celebrating a Muslim holiday in order to promote diversity. Now, wouldn't you do that if you're a Muslim? But you wouldn't cancel Christmas if you're not a Muslim. You would keep the Christmas and do the Muslim holiday in a matter of diversity. But that's not what Obama's doing. He's canceling Christmas. Amazing. Amazing stuff. Okay. Well, now we're going to get into what's going on with the Cable Commission in Maplewood, and this affects all communities. Well, we got a phone call here, so let's take a phone call. Caller, do you have a comment or question?
Well, I have a question, actually.
Okay.
Now, how about the White House? Are they going to celebrate Kwanzaa, too? And what is your stance on celebrating Kwanzaa? I mean, you probably like watermelon and fried chicken, but, you know, we'll go from there.
If people want to celebrate holidays that they establish, they can celebrate holidays. I have no problem with them doing that. I do have a problem with people celebrating holidays that are going to kill people and espouse the destruction of a group of people based on their religion. I don't have a problem stopping a religious belief system that vows to kill you. You know, that's a whole different aspect there. So just for the control room, I'm not going to play that video. We do have video of Betty and Obama with Syrian refugees on the train saying, "May their children be orphans." Okay, so these refugees coming in and they're announcing to the countries that accepted them in, they're doing these chants that "May these countries' children be orphans." There's so many videos out there relating to those type of things and what Muslims are calling for, the destruction of the United States, the great Satan. It isn't just, we're just saying this for our people, it's what they believe. Okay, Maplewood is moving out of the, you will not get to see this show anymore in Maplewood as it stands now. And the city manager sent out this message stating, that's Melinda Coleman, "Maplewood, starting January 1st, Maplewood will produce programs that are currently shown on channels 15 and 16. Okay, this is coming to you on channel 15. So it sounds like the show will be produced and can be seen in Maplewood. Then she expounds, "The shows will relate to government and education programs such as city council meetings, city advisory board and commission meetings," which, by the way, those are already just shown on 16. Okay, they don't need channel 15 to show those. "School district meetings," again, they can show those on 15. "Programs by legislators and other content as determined by the Maplewood City Council. City events and content relating to city business and activities of interest will be continued." Okay, it sounds like these type of shows, because this relates to city events, it can, and this we're talking about it here, and city business will be continued. No, only with the government stamp of approval. And there's a reason why I brought up the LGBT and the Muslim issue. It's the same thing that Hitler did. You got to take over the press, okay? And you're paying $4 and some cents, 20 cents, whatever, to get 8 channels. And now Maplewood has gone out of this franchise agreement here with 11 other cities for a total of 12 cities. And Maplewood says, "We're out of here." And they're going from 8 channels down to 2, but those 2 channels will only deal with government propaganda. Who does that? Who does that? People who are socialist, who are weak-minded, who can't handle criticism, and have no dignity, no respect for other people. That's the type of person that does that. Name me a country or a group of people that do this type of action and take away your liberties and say, "No, we're forcing you to pay for this now." Okay, now it's not an option. Okay, we're forcing you to pay for something and you get less service, and oh, you can only listen to what we provide. Although the laws, well, we're going to get into videos here. Okay, so with this transition to the city deciding content of program, some of the public access shows may not be available. That content may be available in the internet, as many of those content creators simultaneously put on YouTube or other outlets. As we assigned staff and technology early this year, the City Council will decide when and how to expand its programming. I mean, this is nothing short of a communist activity. And people will say, oh, that's too extreme. No, it isn't extreme. People, you need to face up to it. When you behave like that, that's what you are. These people are nothing but communist dictators who are the lowest of the lowest people on earth. You know, and some people think they're good, but they can't articulate an idea. We're going to show some video here pretty quick. And to set that up, the video here, this is talking about a motion before the Maplewood City Council and a public discussion on whether they CenturyLink, a new service, can come into town and have their programming done over the city cable wires. And so that's what this hearing is about. But what I want you to know is everything that the people talked about before the City Council was about this competition issue and what kind of programming should be with CenturyLink. Okay, just like you get Comcast now and you get public access TV, well, we're saying CenturyLink should also have public access TV, but Maplewood wants to shut down these shows. Okay, and they feign, oh, nobody was talking about whether we should have CenturyLink here or not. Well, we did, and we talked about what it should be like. And the mayor goes off and talks about what cable channel should be there and how the cable service will be done. I mean, cable channels like A&E, and will we be able to get CNN? She doesn't say that specifically, but those shows, not related to what her issue, what her business should be, is about providing a service that you're paying for, okay, that's to benefit you. So totally off the line. Well, we got a caller here. Caller, you got a comment or question?
Well, I have more of a comment, and okay. I am one of those Maplewood producers that is affected by this decision. And when I read what they say and I listen to the words they use, I can tell that they really don't have a clear understanding of the decision
right.
that they're making, or even how the technology works.
Right.
Because you've got Miss Melinda Coleman, the city manager of Maplewood, a Plan B city. She is the top dog. She is making the decision.
Yep.
And she is saying that producers simultaneously broadcast their programs on YouTube, on the internet. Well, actually, that is not how it is done.
Nope.
None of the programs are simultaneously broadcast
right.
to the internet. Their city council meetings might be, because they're the government
right.
and they have the wherewithal, the technology, and the money to do simultaneously broadcasting. But all of us who are volunteer producers, we do not have the money, we do not
right.
have the technology, and we do not have the access to simultaneously broadcast to the internet.
That's why there's the public side. Right. That's why there's the public side to the PEG service, public education and government. One is so the government has the money to do it, but it's also so the public has to do it. And so here's the government's going and saying, well, we're going to take all the money and give you less service, and you people can just go out and do your other thing, the public
right.
side. Yeah.
And I want to mention that people whether or not they live in Maplewood or they live in some other community, they have to be startled, aware, and frightened by this movement of Maplewood, a major suburban community, to do this, because it shows that it's a growing trend. There's many smaller communities through the metropolitan area that have let public access die by the wayside or have decided conveniently, like down in Cottage Grove and Woodbury, oh, we don't want to hear the citizens' voice, so we'll just eliminate it. Well, the thing is that in Minnesota, we have a fairly vibrant public access citizen TV network that's right. available to citizen voices. But if you go to the state of Florida, for instance, in the whole entire state of Florida, there is only one access studio that still continues to carry public access programming, and that is in Tampa, Florida.
Wow.
All the other ones
wow.
have been closed down, and all they carry is government or education. Forget what the citizens have to say.
Right. Wow. Oh, that's terrible. Well, that's things to come, and that's, of course, government people doing that. Thank you, caller. Appreciate that. So, you know, does government really care what you think? You know, they say they do. Let's go the Tim 1 video there. This is me speaking before on the CenturyLink thing. And hear what I have to say.
The purpose of the cable franchise or cable business was because the whole concept of cable was to make it functional, you'd get local programming would go away. You'd just have all these national programs, which is mostly cable. And with them needing the right of way to come in, the federal government issued laws that said they keep it local so that there be local programming about local issues, what's going on in the immediate area. And that's why all these franchises or agreements were set up. And so it wasn't just about free speech and being able to see the government in action. It was about able to see what else is going on in the cities and people wanting, whoever wanted to do shows through the public side to they can come in and have some facilities to do that. And so, I mean, we know the intent here is to close down the public side of it. As far as competition goes, great. I think this is a good idea. What I don't like about the situation is Maplewood getting out of the Ramsey County, the Ramsey-Washington County Commission, and just a lot better use and a lot more efficiency with our dollars there. Like Bob said, 9-1. The other issue is about, you know, talking about viewership, we do compete. So there's misinformation out there going on out there. We do compete with other commercial programming. And, you know, you may not like what we have to say, but this is with the purpose of having these cable facilities. And St. Paul does it, Minneapolis does it. Most of the franchises do local programming, the public side, and you're going to eliminate that to the people, which is a form of eliminating free speech and free press, and it goes against the federal purpose of having these franchises. So while I agree with the competition part and CenturyLink should be able to come in and compete, that's really not the emphasis here. We're trying to eliminate competition okay. from the public Mr. competing Kimmler. Against the government.
Just in case people are confused. This is a public hearing regarding cable television franchise.
I want to hear what Nora has to say, but I want to say a few things before she has to say, because she goes into it. People are confused. No, this is the purpose of low cable, what I was talking about, a national program can raise a lot more money than a local program, you know, a public program that's local. National, a lot more potential viewerships, a lot more advertising dollars. A local program, less viewers, less program. But as far as percentage of people who watch the show compared to cable, these shows do really good in that relationship. You know, the 9-to-1 I mentioned, you're going from 9 cable channels down to 2. But that 2 is really only 1 because it's just the government side. Okay, the competition aspect of this is a good thing. But what we're talking about here is that there was a survey done. Okay, and people, this is just outrageous. I can't believe this happened. It's so disgusting. I mean, this just shows you how bad our city council is, and Alan Cantrew, in what he said. There was a survey done by Comcast. This was 2 years ago, okay? Comcast did a survey because they want to see how many people are watching, you know, in order, during a negotiating period of time, in order to shut down and negotiate and say, hey, really, you shouldn't have all this money because people aren't watching. You know, they're really not getting service for this. It's costing us too much money. So Comcast was trying to negotiate. At the same time, guess what was happening? Maplewood was going out. I mean, not Maplewood, but the franchise, Ramsey Washington County Cable Commission, was going out and they conducted their own survey. Okay? Neither of these surveys made the light of day, because an agreement came to be. Okay, so the agreement's gone, the surveys are useless, they're all going to be used for negotiation power. Okay, and then 2 years later now, Alan Cantrute comes out and says, oh, there is a survey done and people aren't watching. Okay, why would he say that? Why would he go out and do this old survey? And what he's doing is actually arguing. He's taking the enemies, in this case, the city is supposed to be working for you. You're paying for the fees. It's coming across your land. The cables are coming through your property. So Comcast to have a right-of-way or CenturyLink to have a right-of-way. He's working for the enemy. He's trying to make the enemy's point. That's treason. He's a Benedict Arnold. He's gone out and is working for the enemy in order to make a worse deal for the city of Maplewood. He's supposed to be on the other side. He's supposed to be on your side. The city council is supposed to be on your side and try to make a better deal. But they're not. So they talk about competition. Baloney. That's a ruse. And you're not going to be able to produce a show if you live in Maplewood that will be seen in Maplewood. All right. So that's what I was talking about. It was about CenturyLink, because you got to deal with Comcast and you're making a worse deal with Comcast than what we had before. And now you're going to take CenturyLink and make an even worse deal. And you're cutting the citizen out of the process, and you're scamming the money off the top. It's a worse deal. And so it was about CenturyLink. It was about what was going on with the agreement with CenturyLink. It was saying, and they know this, make sure we have PEG channels in there too. Make sure we have the public access side. Don't cut it out. And then Nora Slawick has to say this. Let's hear what she has to say.
Broadband services, CenturyLink to provide cable communication services. That's what this hearing is about.
Bingo.
So that is what we're, as a council, taking testimony on. Welcome to the Maplewood City Council.
All right, come back. Don't cut us out of the picture. And she's saying, oh, we weren't talking about the CenturyLink thing when the things we were saying. Yeah, we were. Okay. All right, let's hear what Bob Zick has to say. So go ahead, if you're ready.
Ms. Haig, could you tell us how many people we have to testify and in their order?
You can scoot it forward a little bit.
We have four people that signed up, and one of them did leave. So I know three individuals that have only, and Mark Bradley.
Okay. So we'll start with the first one. If you can come forward, and that would be Mr. Zick. State your name and address for the record, and you have 3 minutes.
Bob Zick, Insight NewsHour, Cable Channel 15, Wednesday night, 8:30 to 9:30 p.m. My information's over there. And people need to get into this discussion and realize what this involves totally with Maplewood getting out of the Ramsey-Washington Cable Commission Joint Powers Agreement. I did read the letter by Mr. Cantrude today, and talk about a twisting and distortion, Alan. That, first of all, this survey that you referred to was actually, I believe, the one that was done by the Ramsey-Washington Cable Commission. So you went through there and picked certain things out. Maplewood gets 70% of the franchise money. Maplewood, the city manager, said that this was going to, by making this move, I believe the number you used, city manager Coleman, was 700,000. Obviously, you're including the PEG fees when you're looking at this, which is $4.20 a month, correct? Well, that's for the, I believe it's 9 channels that is now offered to Ramsey-Washington Cable Commission, that when this goes through, the people in Maplewood will lose 8 channels, 7 for sure. So by no means should Maplewood still collect this $4.20 PEG fee, but in actuality, because the only thing that's going to go out is of course the government message, the government propagandist channel 16. So for that, they should not pay more than 47 cents a month, because that would be the equivalent of what is left for them after you turn the lights out on the other channels. Now, Mr. Cantrude talks about things like in here that, first of all, the study that you used, Alan, was over the whole cable commission area, that only a portion of it involved the city of Maplewood. That, in fact, when I talked to the director out there, the Ramsey-Washington director, that a couple interesting things. That first of all, that the public access is watched more than some of the commercial channels. Second of all, that
Mr.
because
Zick,
of the huge number
up.
Of people that produce,
time
that
up,
live
Mr.
in Maplewood,
we
that
can move on to the next
in
person.
Fact, there is a lot larger okay. viewing audience in Maplewood, and people need to watch the show to have the full discussion of what's happening to them.
Okay.
Next. All right. Very well said. I guess I didn't say that very well. Has nothing to do with CenturyLink. They're going to give you a really bad program. So, people, you need to call Maplewood. You need to call CenturyLink. Make sure all the PEG channels come through. Comcast has to do that. Maplewood still has those channels from Comcast. They're still there. They're separated now into just to Maplewood. And you're going to lose a lot of programming. They say you're going to have the education channel. Probably not. You're not going to see your sports games. You're not going to see your Christmas concerts. Those are done, people. And, you know, by the time you figure it out, it's going to be too late, because Maplewood will have a negotiated away these channels. And do you think they're going to get them back? But guess what? You're going to pay the same amount of money. You know, the financial scales of leveraging the money to get more programming that you did through a big agreement was a lot. You got a lot more service for less money than what you're going to get out of Maplewood. It's going to cost you a lot more, and you're going to get less service. All right, we have a call. Caller, do you have a comment or question?
Yes, I have some comments.
With
regard to what Maplewood residents will not be able to see.
Okay.
Because let's say that they do not care to hear about Maplewood politics. What other kind of programming is it that they won't be able to see, because it's not related to government?
Right.
What the city council decided that they, as Maplewood residents, what they can see about government. Well, you know, people in Maplewood will not be able to see the program that was also on this evening that was put on by the chiropractors, for instance.
Right.
So let's say if you enjoy the program by the chiropractors, who are talking about how to live better through chiropractic, well, you will not get to see that program, because that's not about government.
Right.
Because if city council decides that that program is okay to show, then they got to say it's okay to show Speechless.
Right.
And they're not going to say that chiropractic is okay to listen to, when they would have to say it's okay to listen to Speechless.
Right.
What about the fellow who put together the program on the White Bear Lake Parade?
Right.
I think it's called Slow Motion. Well, yeah. You know, some folks may find that very interesting and a great program to be watching. Well,
yeah.
You know what?
And Maplewood, there's the cooking shows, there's kids shows, there's all kinds of different shows.
Absolutely.
That have nothing to do with government process.
Yes.
Yeah, very, very good point. You're just going to be missing out on a lot of the local creativity that is out in the community. It's too bad. You won't get TV-19 anymore. So it's just on location, all those things where you can find out about the community. Yeah, very much so. Thank you, caller. All right, so essentially you have city council, they're censoring shows. That's the bottom line. We're going to get on to the Human Rights Commission. And so we're just going to start out. We're becoming a sanctuary city without proper notice. So here's my, watch my first video here. Oh, that's on the DVD. I'm sorry, I forgot to tell you. Number 6. So they got to get that loaded up. Human Rights Commission had 3 people there. There's 7 people on this commission. They're supposed to be. But because they selective, they don't let qualified people on the commission, there's only 5. So there's 2 open seats. There's only 3 that showed up. And those 3 voted to pass this sanctuary city thing on to the city council. Who knows? They say the police don't have to approve the it's a police policy, therefore it doesn't have to be approved by anybody. Of course, in this deal, the police are saying we're not going to follow the law. Of course, they expect you to follow the law, but they're not going to follow the law. So let's watch the first video here.
Commissioners, my name is Tim Kinley. I spent all day looking for this. Well, not all day, but 3 hours. Couldn't find it on the website or anything. So I just got it when I walked in here. I haven't had a chance to read it, so I really can't make a comment on the document. I would recommend, though, that after this is done, that you table the decision until next month so people could actually get a copy, because, I mean, is it available online someplace? I mean, I couldn't find it on the Human Rights website, couldn't find it in the packet, couldn't find it on the Facebook page, couldn't find it. So.
It was discussed and distributed at last month's meeting. I don't know if it was published or not, but it was last month's meeting. We discussed it in public.
Right, yeah, I saw that, that you discussed it, but it just didn't happen. So my request is that you table it so I have some time to read this and then make comments based on what the actual policy is versus the perceived policy. And so I'm going to go just some basic oversight here. Some people have said that it's not the police officer's job to do immigrations, it's the feds. That's a misunderstanding. An officer is sworn to uphold the Constitution of the United States and the state constitution and the laws and the statutes. Anything less is, that's not good. This is not about a particular race, whether it's Hispanics, Chinese or whatever. It's about undocumented people, illegal aliens, people that are in here in our country that aren't supposed to be here. And one person said that, well, the accusation is that undocumented people are dangerous. It's irrelevant. Okay, that is not the issue. The issue is that they're here illegally. And the value of these people is extraordinary. It's great. Every individual is so important. They're a gift from God and need to be looked at that way. But this ends up being a safety issue for them. And even though someone can say, hey, you know, they have a fear of reporting a crime, because then they get shipped back. Well, they're the ones that put themselves in that situation, not us. They came in here knowing what they were doing, and they took the risk. I don't blame them. But we can't handle a billion people. You know, there's 7 billion. We can't handle 350 million immigrants coming in. And what's more important is that these people establish a constitution in their own country. I don't know why. I mean, our foreign policy is messed up, but believe me, but why aren't we as a people trying to encourage a declaration of independence in other countries? We don't do that, Republicans or Democrats. Why aren't we pushing a constitution for the countries that they came from to have secured rights? I don't know if there's a time limit here.
You're getting close then, I mean. Yeah.
Okay, I'll wrap it up. So, again, it's about safety for everybody. For them, in particular, I'm concerned about that. I think we all should be, and we should help them thrive in their own lands, in their own countries. Thank you.
It's amazing the risk and the safety risk they will take in order to come into our country. They'll get in the back of vans. They'll cross rivers. People drown. They'll go through deserts. They'll starve. They're at the threat of being looted. Suffocation, all kinds of things. Collapsed tunnels, various things happening in order to get here. And then now when they get here, they're willing to come to the government and say, government, give us these things. Don't send us back. We know we're here illegally. We're criminals. Don't send us back. And if we want to report a crime, don't send us back because that decreases our safety. The reality, they don't care about safety. Okay, they just don't care. Okay, they care about the money they're going to make, and they care about getting the benefits that this country has to offer. If they're willing to go through all that process to get what they're trying to take from Maplewood in the United States, why don't they do that back in their own country? Why don't they push for a constitution that has unalienable rights, rights given by God? Why don't they push that? Why don't they change the constitution of North Korea? Why don't they go change the constitution of Israel? Why don't they go change the constitution of Venezuela or Brazil or Belgium or Germany? Why don't they go change those constitutions instead of sneaking across the border? Let's say Mexico. You know, I didn't mention Hispanics, because all those other groups come across the border in Mexico too. Okay, Arabs, Chinese, are all coming across the border. It just isn't Hispanics or Mexicans. Okay, so that's why it's not a race issue. Push the Constitution. All right. Nobody knows what this policy is. That's just interesting. Well, let's hear what Bob Zick has to say on this. I thought it was very good, very enlightening. Video number 7.
Good evening. I believe, is your correct title, the Human Rights Commission? And I am Bob Zick, Inside Insight News Hour, Wednesday night, 8:30 to 9:30, cable channel 15. Also have business, financial, and property interest in Maplewood. And to that regard, I always find it interesting that the city council, including the mayor over there, always worries about where I live, but seems to not worry about where anybody else that lives here that are criminals for being here illegally. And so I need to know, do our police give a buy on some crimes and not other crimes? So when you subsidize criminal bad behavior, like anything you subsidize, you're going to get more of it. So if you create a haven for criminals that have, by virtue of them coming into this country illegally, you're going to get more of them. You know, I read and I hear this comment about Maplewood now being called Murderwood. And I read that over this last year, the per capita murder rate in Maplewood is the highest of any U.S. city. So I talked to couple of Maplewood police officers, and they don't like the idea of this. You know, I don't know, I'm sure they're not going to express that to the chief, but they did to me. And so, you know, I look at this Trojan horse that France gave this country. And that Trojan horse says, give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses, your wretched refuge from your teeming shores. I think it's time that we also add on to that your terrorists, your criminals, and all others you do not want in your country, like Castro sent us when he emptied his prisons. And above all, do not question their purpose for being here, and allow them all benefits of any other citizen. So I look at the situation that we are creating and realize that, yes, it may be good for surrounding cities because we're going to have everybody that wants to operate outside the law move to Maplewood. So, yes, it'll keep Mendota Heights lovely, and it'll keep North St. Paul lovely, but it's not going to do anything for Maplewood. When we look at this, that when we bring these illegal criminals, no, we don't bring them here. They come in here through our porous borders. And the cost to the citizens that are here that came here legally, you know, it cost us $19,000 per year per child to put them in our schools. They're entitled to all the other social service programs that we fund.
Mr. Zick, if you wouldn't mind wrapping up, we're close on time.
Yes, okay. Not to mention the downward pressure they put on the living wage earners. So when the President Kennedy so correctly said that ask what you can do for the country, not what the country can do for you. And when these criminals come in here, it's what the country can do for them. It's not about we're here for this country. It's we came here because it's an economic gain and we want to benefit from the hard work of everybody that are here as legal citizens. Thank you, Commission.
Okay, thank you.
So what we end up is a police chief that established a policy that will violate state law. There was one person there that said, from what I can understand, that they were a illegal alien, a criminal. They didn't use those words. And the police chief is just sitting there, you know. So he's selectively enforcing laws, you know, that the people have said, we want these enforced. What ended up happening then, there was some kickback and it just from the Human Rights Commission, and they just established, you guys are saying he, they, you know, and you're making it a race issue. It didn't matter what we said, that it wasn't a race issue, okay? They just said it anyway, you know, and that's what was going on there. We're just, Human Rights Commission, we're going to say what we want to say, whether it dealt with anything we were talking about or not. And so safety, you know, the point was safety. It's we need to have safety for the immigrants, the criminals coming in, rather than saying, realizing that we were talking about safety for the criminals, okay? And that you're better off safe in your own country than coming here because you're going to be exploited by bad people. We have bad people here. So you're going to be exploited by them. You can't report crimes of rape. This is demeaning to women, this whole process. And so you're better off staying in your own country, and you better fight for liberties down there than here, because you're not protected, and you're just going to be used. Well, so I fought back when that comment was made. I spoke again, so let's hear what I have to say.
Yeah, Tim Kinley, Maplewood, Chair, Commissioners. There's comments made about things that I said that I did not say. And I was accused of saying things I did not say. This is not a race issue. This is not a demographics issue. Like I said, it's about people from all nationalities who come into this country violating our laws by coming in. That's what it's about, okay? It is about safety. It's about their safety, and it's about our safety. But I don't know what the policy is, okay? I've heard what people have said it is, but I don't know because it just came today. You know what? That's a human rights violation, not having proper notice. Maybe I should file a complaint against Officer Police Chief Schnell there and the commission. I mean, to pass this, with this just coming out right now, you can talk about it all you want. It's what the words say and what they mean. This is not what we do, okay? So to make that this is about a demographic, about a group of people, is never about that. And I agree with you wholeheartedly. Like I said, every single person is valuable. But not everybody that comes into this country has our values. There are people that want to destroy us and destroy this country and to destroy the liberties that we do have. They don't like us because we have the liberties. They want a theocracy or whatever. So at least if you're going to argue against somebody, argue correctly.
Yeah, they may want a theocracy. They may want to be a socialist, like our city council. They may want to limit free speech, like our city council. You know, the whole issue, go through the right process, be vetted in the right way. Of course, that whole issue of vetting is now under scrutiny, as it well should be. But boy, I don't have any problem with immigration. People want to follow our laws and come into our country the legal way, not a problem. But that's not what's happening. And we're talking about normal Muslims who are trying to destroy our country. The bad Muslims aren't. Those are the ones that don't follow Muhammad. The ones that are following Muhammad are coming in and are going to cause us harm. All right, remember, if you don't stand up for other people's liberties, who's going to stand up for yours? And good men don't do nothing. God bless. Have a great week. You said to me that you wouldn't leave, but now I see that you're lost. Days gone.